What's going on, rail fans? Flamerailzzz here. Today we will be doing the first session in the Tri-Brook and Esopus Valley Railroad route by approach medium of jointed rail. You guys seem to like the last session that we ran on the Mojave subdivision, the Waylong Stall. So today, we will do another session to see how you guys like this one. I'm quite excited to do this one. Alright. Forgive me if I butcher the name. Fleischman's Gravel Run. Today, you will be bringing an empty hopper train up to Fleischman's Gravel and bringing the loads back downgrade into the valley for interchange with Conrail. This session may be a bit more difficult if operating with cab controls due to the heavy grade from driver. Good luck. Length, 2 hours. Difficulty, normal. Alright, I operate in cab mode 24/7. So, let's see what the challenge may be. Good morning. Today you will be running up to Fleischman's to switch out their gravel loads. On your way back, you'll need to switch out the covered hoppers at Gill's Farms. Okie dokie. All junctions are manual. Obey all speed limits and make sure every crossing lights for proceeding. First, alright. There's our hoppers there we need to couple. First, empty gravel hoppers on track 3. Will do. Alright. Turn some of these settings down to improve performance a tad bit more. Pretty rough track conditions. Junction ahead is not thrown, so I'll throw that. A little bit too fast there. Alright. Easy. Shouldn't have to do nothing. Let it roll. Never mind. Alright. Clear to proceed west to Fleischman sighting. Pay attention at all crossings and watch out for soft spots and broken rail. Will do. Track maintenance crews not doing their job. It's lovely. Now I've got to take extra caution when doing mine. But let's head on up to Fleischman's. Speedometer anywhere in this cab? I'd like to know. How fast I'm going. If not, then, oh well. guys happy that I turned that annoying bell off? I know. I know. We've got some ways to go. Let's check our... Train length, 700 feet. 730 feet. So we should have a little bit of a... leeway to kind of, you know... give it get up to speed after a certain amount of time. Alright, I'll leave the class lights off. Alright, let's get moving. No, we have a crossing coming up. Don't mind me, guys, just grabbing a few shots. The real fun is coming. Got about seven miles to go or something. So, let's see the challenge of this grade. I see 2.3 coming up on the track chart. And it looks like we're already climbing. I didn't look at the 0.9 for 6th grade we're currently on. So, let me maintain speed, get us up to speed again. Okay, yeah, let's switch back. Whoops. Alright, it's one speed violation. Let the train roll for a minute. Let's zoom in on the track profile. Let's zoom out for a second. Alright. Looks like we're going downhill for a slight. Then here comes the climb. kick up the notches a little bit. Speed violations is that? Yeah, you guys can put F's in the chat for me. Alright, I should be down to speed now, yep. Looks like a whistle board. Got a milepost board. And it's a milepost board, that's all. Does that say 7? Wait a minute. Okay. I was about to say, no, I know that. Guys, that had me going there for a second. I thought that was 7% grade. I was like, what? Whoa, wait, what? Alright, I need to zoom out and track the profile a little bit. Because, that had me for a second there. I'm like, well, wait a minute. Yeah. That's a little bit overkill. Oh, come on. Oh, wait, no. Make sure I maintain the speed. Take it down a notch. Nice salt. Alright, looks like it kind of levels out for about the next 5-6 miles. Alright, so this is the final climb. Awesome. And the grade is dropping. So that means I can completely drop my throttle. Has been completed. Wait a minute. I'll probably have to run with the Jeep in the lead then. 2 miles, 2.5 miles remaining. Boys, hang in there. We've been at it for 30 minutes, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong. I haven't been paying attention to the timestamp in the corner up here. This is lovely. This is a lovely route. And for any of you that may have been wondering about the, you know, the railroad crossings and such, the route is primarily made for Trainz A New Era, Service Pack 3 and above. So, the TRC crossing assets don't properly function sometimes in Trainz 2019. So that's why they can kind of cause those hiccups in the crossings not activating. But nevertheless, it doesn't take away from the experience of the route too much. But I would highly advise you guys to be aware of the messages that the team at Jointed Rail leaves for you guys when it comes to routes, and not just routes, any content that these guys release, or really for any website for that matter. These developers leave messages for you guys, so that way you are aware of what's compatible with whatever version of Trainz you might have, and what might not be compatible with your version of Trainz. So I advise you guys to take note and take heed to those messages, as they can take or give to your experience with Trainz. With me, satisfied. I know you guys are probably watching, like, it takes one more screenshot. I know. These are just for the bros. These are for the bros. And maybe a couple for the video. Just if I'm being honest. Alright. 1.5 miles. We're almost there. Looks like we're on a slight decline. So I might let the nope. Like it's not really a consistent decline. Looks like it's kind of a roller coaster here. Let's see. Where's the freaking speedometer at? Fuel. Air. Oil. Air. a mile. We're right here. The trip uphill was fun. The downhill part is going to be a little bit more interesting. Alright. Let's take a look at the map. What track am I supposed to arrive on? Alright, yeah, looks like I'm on the right track. Set the braking to minimal. Right about there. Initial should be fine. Yes, might be butter. It might be butter, maybe not, no. Probably not. Right here. At this point, you'll need to pull the loaded gravel hoppers and spot the empties. Once you have your train reassembled, proceed east to Drybrook and wait for further orders. Lovely. Okay, so, let's see. Let me look at my session instructions again. Alright. So I need to couple. Let me just take a look around. Kind of. Alright. These are loaded ones I'm supposed to grab. Ah, I see what it's asking me to do. Okay, I think I know. I think. Let me look back at the session. Switch out. Other hopper to do hard. Okay, so it looks like I'm supposed to decouple these. If I'm wrong, I'll bite the bullet. Alright. So, perhaps I'm supposed to pull forward. Where's the switch thrown? Good. Something that's good. Let's see. Yep. Pull them up. Park them. Bring them to empties. This is just great. Low speed limits are killing me. Nevertheless, press on, soldier. Here we go. and luckily there's not too many gravel hoppers for me. Let me think. How am I going to do this? Game of chess. I hate chess, but I'm gonna be good at it today. So, reverse and yes, this is a game of chess. There's a lot of switching work up that'll have to be done here. Alright, now I understand why the session is 2 hours. Okay, well then. Let me just figure out my strategy here. Alright, so if I reverse the train, I bring it back down, my engines will be right at the hoppers. First, park freight cars, the loaded freight cars. Where am I going to park the empty? Let me figure that out first. Let me pause so I don't waste game time. This is really a game of chess, but alright. Not gonna lie to you guys, I'll probably have to cut this part out just because it's probably gonna take me forever to think here. Alright, switching work.
Hey, I know this is completely parallel to me. Probably have to use this as a right round.
Now that I've devised my plan, I think it's going to work. Asking me to couple these. Bring them down and bring those empty ones up there. These hoppers are a little bit too close to the point of my return for my comfort. I don't like that. Don't like it. I don't. Well, it looks like we kind of just killed some vegetation there. My bad. Didn't mean it. Cause agricultural damage. No, correction. Environmental damage. That's what that, yeah. Now this is the easy part. All I gotta do is run the engines and running around. Run the engines up and get them coupled. independent braking now. Oh, I should have done it a while ago, but hey. Let's back that up. Alright. Let us go and get these hoppers. I'm gonna let the train roll because the gradient is going downward. Apply. Boom. Finally. Let's go snag the hoppers. Pantograph icon going here. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, let's see if I still got my magic touch. Perhaps... lost it? Perhaps I... Okay, well then, that's a... Okay. Oh, we got him. We got him, ladies and gentlemen. Alright, let's, wait a minute. This is the Jeep. Alright, I haven't operated this thing in a minute. Crap. Alright, at least this one has a visible speedometer, so... Let's setup, throttle, dynamic braking, that's what that is. They gave me a stop marker. Okay. Oh no. That's enough. Okay. See how we're playing this. Well, luckily I devised a plan anyway, so it doesn't matter. How many hoppers did I bring? I brought 8 hoppers. How many am I picking up? Brought 8 and I'm picking up 8. Wonderful. My stop literally has to be precise. Has to be exact. Have any speed restrictions coming up that I should know about? No. Alright, so let's see if we can get this right this time. Set the braking to initial. I'll get it down to about maybe 12. No, 10. 10. Looks like that last hopper just cleared it. Alright. Perfect. No, 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 no. That's what I was afraid of. Okay, yeah, next time I'm stopping the train further back. I don't care about that marker. Get that marker, yeah. Let's get this thing in reverse. Wait a minute. Do I have to bring the... I feel like I'm supposed to bring the hoppers up the hill. So I'm gonna bring them up the hill and then we're gonna head on our way. You know what? Yeah, there's really no... really no, yeah. I'll just, bring the hoppers up the hill, and, we'll, be right back.